Hi, I'm Dr. Palm from Art of Skin MD in San Diego, California, and today Mandy and I are going to be here talking to you a little bit about Restylane Silk. It is FDA approved and it's going to be coming out in the next few weeks, so I wanted to talk a little bit about it because I've done a little research and actually written about it as well. So it's going to be FDA indicated. I'm going to use Mandy as an example. Around the lips, actually for lip filling, it's going to be indicated in the lip, and then those fine little smoker's lines and laugh lines and what we call sort of fine lines around the mouth, it's also going to be helpful for. But off label, it's likely that a lot of expert dermatologists that are adept at filling will use it in other areas. So, you know, it probably could be used in fine lines around the crow's feet if people are getting those horizontal neck lines in that area. Anywhere you've got a little fine line and you want something softened. It's really interesting. It's in the Restylane group. It's just a smaller particle size, so it's meant for sort of more superficial filling and little fine lines. So a couple other things to add. So this is our standard Restylane. Perlane is a big particle. Restylane is kind of mid-particle, and Restylane Silk is going to be the tiniest particle in this sort of family, and that's why it's going to be so good for fine line filling. So what will it kind of compete against? I think the closest product we have in the market here in the US is something called Bellatero Balance, which is also great around that area, is a hyaluronic acid, just like Restylane will be. So it's almost kind of like a hybrid between the two. So if you want to have more information, you have access to medical journals. I've got an article that's coming out next month in the Seminars in Cutaneous Medicine and Surgery, where I'm going to be talking about new fillers that are hitting the market. And that includes things like Restylane Silk, things that have been out for a little while, such as Bellatero Balance and Voluma, and then other things that are coming down the pipeline like Volbella, which we're really excited for in the next several years. And just to give you an idea of sort of how we use this, so this is a slide that's showing this technique. So it's very superficial placement. After a patient is numbed, you're going to do little teeny blebs in the areas where the fillers are. This shows a patient immediately after injection, so they can have a little bit of blanching or lightening of the skin as a result of the placement, and also if an anesthetic is added to that area. And then this is representative. This is actually from Bellatero, but I think we'll probably see similar results from Restylane Silk here in the US, showing nice improvement around what we call the perioral area or around the mouth, helping chin creases, helping lines around the mouth, and even for augmentation of the lip as well. So if you have more questions, come find us or come see us at artofskinmd.com.